Ed Reardon's Week by Christopher Douglas and Andrew Nickolds. Episode 1, The Swim.
Monday. It is the morning of my 52nd birthday. Not that you'd know that from the Today's Birthdays column of The Guardian or The Telegraph, or The Independent in its pocket-sized version for pocket-sized brains. The only consolation is that my brother scribblers Nick Hornby and Tony Parsons have been omitted too, though I have to admit the possibility that it may not be their birthdays.
Hello. Why has it gone into Times New Roman? Ah, that's better. Baskerville irascible.
Being left off the list is an error first perpetrated 20 years ago and repeated annually since then, despite phone messages from 1985, faxes from 1989, and emails from 1998. A text message with an unsmiley face last year, and as of today, a jiffy bag filled with the contents of Elgar's litter tray. I would have checked the Times, the Express, and the Mail to see if my humiliation was complete, but for the intervention of my friendly local newsagent.
Are you going to buy any of those papers?
No, I'll just take a copy of the local free sheet. Suburbo. Honestly, what 12-year-old genius came up with that?
That's 35p where sold, mate.
Oh, just give me a tin of whiskers then. No, in jelly. The gravy one goes everywhere.
47 pence.
I see from the new Suburbo that giant Asda plan spells death knell threat for local shops. Oh dear. A mixed metaphor, but quite effective. 45, 47.
Thank you, sir. Good morning.
Morning to you. Or is it goodbye?
Normally, I'd get a 50-length swim in before lunch, but I decide that if Ed Reardon's birthday is to feature in 12 months' time, then bull's horns must be grabbed and bullets bitten. So, pausing only to put the Barclay card and egg checks in the wrong envelopes, and catching an hour's cricket from Auckland before rain interrupts play, I put in a call to my agent.
In the Faroe Islands, or wherever it is you moved to.
Berkhamsted.
Oh, well, good for you.
Oh, well, it's the best thing I've ever done, Felix. I mean, there's a pool round the corner, so I never get ill. There's a Threshers between here and the station, the Blockbuster at the bottom of the hill. I mean, I'm living above a chip shop, for goodness sake, and it's... Well, it's quicker to get into town than when I had the house in Camden. I mean, I wish I'd split up with that woman years ago.
Well, there you are, you see. You've stolen a march on us again. I wish I had the courage to uproot instead of being stuck in Knightsbridge. Well, it's been lovely to talk to you.
The thing is, Felix, I've got a lot of ideas to run past you. Idea number one, it's 30 years since Who Would Fardel's Bear was published.
30 years? Good Lord, have we been together that long? Dreadful.
Yes, God, isn't it? Yeah. Anyway, I was thinking about an anniversary reissue, and then there's the film idea I sent you.
I must fire my secretary. In fact, I'll fire all my secretary's idle clutch of flutes.
Tuesday. With lunch with Felix booked in for tomorrow, it was vital to get in 100 lengths at the pool as a prophylactic measure against the orgy of excess that he insists on inflicting on his favoured clients. However, I was overwhelmed to receive birthday presents from my ex-wife and children, only a day late. A display of filial affection rivaling the book token that arrived 3 weeks after my heart attack. Oh, look, Elgar. Another copy of that bloody woman's punctuation book. What's this one? Oh, that makes a full set. How much are you going to get for this? Well, the cover price is $9.99, so 12.5%. Elgar, off the calculator. Come on, Daddy's working.
9.99 times 3 times 12.5%.
Oh, £3.75. How lovely for her. Whose birthday is it? Eats, shoots, leaves, and throws book across living room!
I was sadly forced to forego the swim due to having to wait in for the glaziers. Or is it glaziers with an apostrophe?
A lot of books here, mate.
Yes.
Did you write them all?
No.
Bet you wish you'd written this one.
Changed my life, I'll tell you that. Turned out I'd been using the semicolon incorrectly for years.
Wednesday. While searching for my Berkhamsted Leisure Centre over 50s pass in the pockets of my yellow cords prior to the morning swim, I discover, as well as the Burko card, the unstamped return half of a train ticket to London, valid at peak times. Heartened by this good omen, I set off at 9:15 for lunch with my agent. This, however, turns out to be a misnomer on both counts. I appear to have been downsized or outsourced or whatever non-word the 12-year-olds are using these days for being thrown on the scrap heap, unceremoniously, without even a black bin liner to protect me from the rats and scavenging seagulls on the scrap heap pecking away at my rotting entrails.
Mr. Reardon?
Ah.
Hi, I'm Ping.
Well, that's very clever of you. Mm. How did you recognise me?
Oh, you're carrying a copy of your book? We handled the publishing deal, you know.
Ah, well, I hope you don't think I make a habit of this sort of thing.
No, because it must be quite valuable. Can't be many left in circulation now.
This is true. But as I said to Felix, next year will be the 30th anniversary of Who Would Fartles Bear? So we might be able to persuade the publishers to reissue.
Well, right. I'm not sure they still do fiction. They're more Second World War and erotic massage books these days. Felix says sorry, by the way.
What for?
Not being able to make it. Actually, what he said was, je suis désolé. But he'd just come off the phone talking to Thierry Henry about his new novel, so...
How's that going?
Oh, it's going to be a monster. I wrote the proposal, yeah?
I wish they'd put you on the cover. Mm. I'd buy it then. Buy a dozen copies. Better than that wretched punctuation woman.
That's a compliment, right?
Oh, yeah. But look, I see from my newspaper that the film that was based on Who Would Fartles Bear is coming out on DV, is it?
Oh, yeah, Sister Mom, I saw it last night and I'm like, wow, what a great movie this is.
Uh-huh.
Because I wasn't even born when it first came out.
Uh-huh.
And I'd always heard, you know, Sister Mom was one of Jazz Milvane's seminal early works.
Well, yeah, he did a reasonable job. So I was thinking that in view of all the brouhaha, this might be the time to talk to Felix about a new edition of Who Would Fartles Bear? Mm. Yeah, they put a picture of Sally Field on the cover if they want. Why not six-month-old Scarlett Johansson too?
Or Johnny Wilkinson. We put him on a lot of books.
So, should we have a couple of drinks here or head straight for a martini or three at the Caprice?
Actually, would you mind if we ate here? You see, I've only been allocated £17.50 for this lunch. Though we could share a starter.
So, there it was. I'd been downgraded. As far as my agents were concerned, henceforth Ed Reardon's career journey would be made on board a no-frills airline. Naturally enough, I made the best of it, though I can't remember trying to make myself comfortable on a barrel since the school production of Treasure Island. E.F. Reardon's Squire Trelawney effortlessly achieves an aristocratic disdain. The Salopian, 1961. My first review. I still got it somewhere.
I hope you don't mind me saying this, but I love your work.
Oh, you're very kind. Mm. I admit I wasn't totally displeased with Who Would Fartles Bear. Oh,
Jane Seymour's Household Hints. I really thought you got Jane there.
Yeah, well, it's all writing, isn't it? If you're a professional. But I like to think that some of the novel I had set aside at the time rubbed off on Jane.
Sadly, I didn't see your episode of Tenko, but I have to say the Brown's Hatch story. Whoa, it was like actually being in the pits with Damon Hill.
That's possibly because I copied most of it out of Damon Hill's History of Formula One.
When that driver crashed and went like... Wow, it was so gross. I mean, I just went by tube for a week.
Thank you, Pink.
So when it came to restructuring the client list, I'm like, oh, can I have Ed Reardon, please?
Well, I think that calls for another bottle. Please.
Hello. Actually...
And I don't want this okay-aged, Mark. Give me a cab sav, matey, will you?
But I want you to understand that Felix Jeffrey Associates will continue to offer you the service that, you know, da-da, blah-de-blah.
Well, if Felix has passed me on to you, I suppose you'd better hear my plans. Hmm. Let's start with television. Dumped down to the point of imbecility these days, but one has to eat. Thank you. Essentially, Bouquet of Bamboo is a miniseries exploring the burgeoning sexual attraction between a group of English women and their Japanese prison guards after the war. Come on, drink up.
I prefer the Shiraz, actually. The thing is, there's something come in that we think has Ed Reardon written all over it.
Right. It's not a repeat fee.
Pet Peeves.
Pet Peeves. Ah, another vet series. God spare us. All right, how many episodes do they want?
It's a book. Sal's ear want to do it. They're good people. Oh. Well, basically, the brief is celeb cats and dogs grumbling about their owners.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.